A very good morning to all the students. This video for the class 7th subject science, chapter number 12, that is the reproduction in plants. This is your lecture number 1. Next is the topics to be covered. So I'm going to cover the topics in this chapter, that is the reproduction in plant. So the first topic that we are going to cover is activity first, activity second, activity third and activity fourth. Second topic is about the reproduction. Third one is the modes of the reproduction in plants. Fourth one is the type of reproduction. Fifth one is the different type of the asexual reproduction. Then we will study the different type of the asexual reproduction. Okay, so let us begin this lecture with the first topic, that is activity first. So the aim is the vegetative propagation by the stem cutting. So you have to take a sharp knife, cut a piece of a rose branch about the 12 inches long with at least one or two nodes and a few buds are there. Okay, then put this cutting in soil and water it every day. So you have to put this cutting in the soil and water it every day. Then after a few days, you will observe the new leaves and branches coming from the bud at the nodes of the cutting. So as you can see in this picture, firstly, cut the piece of a rose branch about the 12 inches. Okay, at least long with at least one or two nodes are present in this the branch. Okay, this is called cutting. So put this cutting into the soil and water it every day. So after a few days, you will observe there the new leaves are and the branches coming from the bud at the nodes. Here, there the several nodes are present. From these nodes, the leaves and the branches are coming. Okay, at the same time, the root will also emerge from the part of the cutting buried in the soil. So you will observe that in less than a month, it grows into a new plant with the branches, with the leaves and with the rose flower. So this is a vegetative propagation by the stem cutting. Okay, next is the activity second. So you have to take the fresh potato and observe the scar on it with the help of a magnifying glass. Okay, you may find several birds in that. Then cut the potato into the small portions, each with an eye, and bury them into the soil. Water the piece regularly for the few days and observe their progress. So you have to take the fresh potato, observe there are the several scars on it with the help of the magnifying glass. So you may find these birds into them. Okay, so then you have to cut the potato into the two, the small portion, or you can cut it into the four small portion, each with an eye, and bury them into the soil. So give them water every day regularly for the few days and observe their progress. So after few days, you will observe that these are the scar or the scale leaves. Okay, and these are the eye bud, that is the germinating eye bud. Okay, after some time, this bud or that is a new shoot developing from the buds. This is a new shoot that is developing from these eye bud. After some day, you will observe that a new plant is grow from each cut piece of a potato as the buds grow into the new plants. These are the buds here. These germinating eye buds, after some time, they grow into a new plant, a new potato plant. Okay. Next is activity third. The aim of this activity is to observe the budding in yeast. Firstly, the procedure is take a small packet of the yeast from any bakery and add a pinch of it in a bowl of water. Then add a spoonful of sugar and leave at a warm place for about 1 hour. then put a drop of this liquid on the glass slide and observe under a microscope. What do you observe? So you observe a drop of it under a microscope. You have to observe a drop of it under a microscope. Then you will be able to see there are the number of yeast cell with buds. That is the budding. Okay, budding is the asexual reproduction where the small part, the yeast cell, the small part of the parent plant grow into a bulb-like projection. Okay, this is the developing bud. A new bud is a bulb-like projection called bud. So, which on getting detached, after some time it get detached and produce a new bud or a new yeast is formed. Next is the activity 4. In activity 4, you have to take the mustard or you can take the China rose or a tunia flower and separate its reproductive part. Then study the various parts of the stamen and pistil. So you have to study the various reproductive parts of a plant. You can take the China rose, mustard rose, mustard, China rose or the tunia flower. So you will observe that on the upper part the stigma is present. That is the female reproductive part. Here the carpel is the complete female reproductive part. That is, it carries the stigma, style and ovary. So the first swollen part is the stigma. This is the style, that is the longest style, and at the basal is the ovary part. This is the female reproductive part. On another hand, the anther and filament. So the bilobe structure, that is anther, and the stalk that is present below the anther, that is filament. So it form a male reproductive part in plant, that is stamen. So stamen and carpel, these are the male reproductive part and the female reproductive part. So you have to study the various part of the stamen and pistil. Okay. Next is the first topic is reproduction. So as you all know about that, the reproduction is, that is the most important characteristics of all the living organism to produce their young ones or to produce their own kind. That is reproduction. So the all living organism have a characteristics that they can produce their own kind. So this production of the offspring from the parents is called reproduction. The reproduction is a process from where they can reproduce their own kind. The living organism is reproduce their own kind, that is reproduction. Okay, the production of a new organism from the parent organism is also called reproduction. Next is the modes of the reproduction in plants. There are the two main types of reproduction. First is the vegetative reproduction part, or we can say the asexual reproduction, and second is the sexual reproduction. So this vegetative part are the type of the asexual reproduction. Here the vegetative parts, these are the parts of the plant that play a major role in the life cycle of a plant, such as the preparation of the food, transportation of the food, transportation of the water and nutrient and etc. For example, root, stem, leaves, these are the vegetative parts. Okay. Next is about the reproductive part. So these parts of a plant play also a major role in the reproduction process. Okay. For example, to making a flower, to making a fruit from the plant. First is the asexual reproduction, second is the sexual reproduction. So in asexual reproduction, first is the vegetative part. So new plants are formed from the vegetative parts of the plant, like the roots, stems or leaves. In reproductive part, the new plants are formed from the seed of the plant or the flower or the fruit. These are the reproductive organs that produce the seeds. Okay. Next is the types of reproduction. Reproduction in plants can be categorized into the two types, the asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction. So the asexual reproduction, the new plants are produced without using the seed. So in this process, generally the leaves, stem and roots participate in reproduction. Okay, this is the asexual reproduction. Asexual reproduction plants mean new plant are produced from the existing plant without the formation of seed. Okay, from the one plant, many plants can be formed. Next is the sexual reproduction. The new plants are produced with the help of the seeds of a plant. So in this process, the flower of the plant participate in the reproduction. Okay, this is the sexual reproduction in plant. Or we can say the flower are the reproductive organ in the flowering plant. That is, flower is said to be a modified part of the plant for sexual reproduction. Next is the different type of asexual reproduction. Now we are going to study about the different type of the asexual reproduction. First is vegetative reproduction, that is the vegetative propagation by roots. The vegetative reproduction, from the new plants are formed from the vegetative parts. Okay, like a root, stem and leaves. As the name suggests, this type of reproduction, it takes place with the help of the vegetative parts. Vegetative parts are stem, roots and leaves. Only the one parent can produce the identical offspring in vegetative propagation. So in this vegetative propagation by root, in some plants the roots are modified to store the food. So this is a picture of a sweet potato. So here the roots are modified to store the food as in the sweet potato. Okay, so these such roots have the buds on them. The buds are not present on the roots of the plant, which can grow to produce a new sweet potato plant. So from one root of the sweet potato, many plants can be reproduced. So this is the vegetative propagation by the roots. Next is the vegetative propagation by the stem. So just like the tuberous root, like the sweet potato, some plants have the tuberous stem. So these stem tubers store the nutrient and bears some nodes. So these nodes bear the buds that form the new plant, for example potato. So in vegetative propagation by stem, many plants like rose, China rose and potato, they can easily grown by the stem cutting. So plant like a potato, so also called a potato tuber, because they have the underground stem. Firstly, observe a potato carefully. Okay, you will be able to see where the some scars is present on it. So take the magnifying glass. Okay, and you might be able to see there is a tiny birds in some scars. These are the birds, tiny birds in the scars. So these scars are commonly called as eyes. Okay, these scars are commonly called as eyes. So each one of the eye contain a eye bud, which is capable of developing a new plant. So when you cut this potato into a number of pieces, with each piece it containing a few buds or eyes. So after that you will observe that the new plant is grow from each the cut piece of the potato. So bud grows into the new plant is the vegetative propagation by stem. And another example are ginger and turmeric can also be grown the same way as the potato tuber is grown. Next is the vegetative propagation by leaves. Some plants have leaves that contain buds that can develop into a new plant. For example, bryophyllum. So the plant bryophyllum, or we can say the sprout leaf plant, has the bud along the margin of the leaf. So in this picture you can easily see that these buds birds along the margin of the leaf. These are the birds. Okay, these birds that are present along the margin of its leaf. So during the favorable condition, develop from these birds. If a leaf of a bryophyllum with the birds or the plantlets fall on a moist soil, so the bud grows into a new independent plant. Okay, firstly, during the favorable condition, when the conditions are favorable for growing this plant, that it develops from the these birds. So this bryophyllum with the birds or the plantlets, these falls on a moist soil and the bud grows into a new plant or new bryophyllum plant. Okay. In the same way, in a cacti plant, the green part that we see is a stem. So when any of its stem, the part get detached from the main plant, so each detached part can grow into a new plant. From one cacti, many cacti can be grown. So this is vegetative propagation by the leaves in bryophyllum. Next is the artificial means of the vegetative propagation. So in cutting, it is a method that these are the artificially vegetative propagation. It is the method in which cutting from a plant is taken and then it planted. So this cutting is a part of a stem or the branch of the plant. For example, rose. We can see the cutting artificial method, that is the basic stem cutting in rose. So when we cut the stem or the cut the branch of the rose plant and we grow that branch cutted plant with the nodes point into the soil, so after some time you will observe that there are some several roots are growing from that branch, that cutted plant. Okay, so these planted root produce a new shoot and it grows into a new plant of a rose plant. Next is the grafting method. Grafting is sometime when the two plants are joined together so that both of them can provide the desired characteristics to the new plant. That is grafting. In the one plant remain rooted into the ground, which is called stalk, and provide the essential nutrient and water, while the other plant stem is attached to it, that is kyon. So in this way, a new plant developed. For example, in apple. Yeah, this is a picture. This cone is the part that is going to be attached to this stalk. Okay, after the grafting, we reunion these two branches of different plant and wrapped it and waxed it. Okay, so it grow into a new plant, that is grafting. Next is the advantages of the vegetative propagation. The first advantage is the plant that are produced with vegetative propagation, they grow faster than those that are produced with sexual reproduction. Second, the plants that reproduce with vegetative reproduction, they have the fruit and flower ahead of time. Third, the plants that are produced have the exactly the same characteristics as that of their parents. Or we can say it is an easier or the less expensive and the rapid way of producing the new plant. Okay, in vegetative propagation, plant takes less amount of time to grow. And plant in vegetative propagation, plant cannot produce the proper seeds like banana, pineapple, so it can be easily grown. Okay. Next, asexual reproduction is about budding. So, budding is a type of asexual reproduction where the small part of the parent plant grow into a bulb-like projection, that is bud. So, yeast is an organism that contain a single cell. So it is a fungi, not a plant. It can propagate every few hours. if the proper amount of nutrients are present at that time. As the yeast find the favorable condition, when the yeast find the favorable condition, a small bulb-like projection produced from the yeast that called bud. Okay, which on getting detach and produce a new plant. First, yeast is a single cell small plant. It's a fungus, we cannot say it's a plant. So that can be seen with a microscope only. So yeast, a bud start as a small outgrowth on the surface of mature yeast. Okay. So the bud grows gradually and then get detached from the parent yeast, and this new cell grow measles and produce more cells. So firstly, yeast is a single cell. As you can see, this is a single-celled organism. Okay, it's a fungus that can be seen. We can easily see with the help of a microscope. A bud start. This is a developing bud. So this bud start as a small outgrowth on the surface of the mature yeast cell. As it enlarge, it get detached. After that, when it enlarge, it get detached and form a new yeast cell. So every new yeast cell that is formed produce more and more yeast cell by the help of budding process. Okay, sometime a new bud arises from another bud, that is a chain of a yeast bud. Okay, this is the reproduction in yeast by budding. Next is the fragmentation. It's a type of asexual reproduction. Fragmentation, the algae like a Spirogyra generally reproduce by the process of fragmentation. Spirogyra is the example of a process of fragmentation in which they divide themselves into multiple parts. Fragmentation means breaking of an organism into many parts. Here, fragmentation. So, breaking of organism into many parts, that is fragmentation. So, as soon as the algae find enough water and nutrient, it's fragment and grow into the new individual. When the favorable condition is available for the algae, the fragment get separated and grow into a new individual part. So this process continues and algae multiply quickly in a short period of a time. So as you can see that when each fragment, these are the fragment of the Spirogyra, okay, when each fragment give rise to a new plant, it is called the reproduction by the fragmentation. It is seen in the filamentous green algae like a Spirogyra. So here, during the favorable condition, when water and nutrients are available in plenty, this Spirogyra filament break into the two or more fragments. So each fragment grow into a new Spirogyra. So by the fragmentation, the Spirogyra spread very fast in a very short period of time. Okay, and it covers a large area in a pond. That is the fragmentation in Spirogyra. Next is the spore formation. It is also a type of asexual reproduction. Some plants contain the spores that float in the air and cause asexual reproduction. It is a common method of the reproduction in number of fungi like a bread mold or fern and mosses. So the spores are the asexual reproduction body. A spore has a hard protective cover which protects it from the unfavorable environment condition like the temperature, humidity. Because of the hard covering, the spores can travel long distance and survive for a long duration of time. As soon as they find the favorable condition such as moisture and nutrient, they germinate and form a new plant. You can see the germination, the spore formation in the moss and fern and bread mold. So here you can see the during the favorable condition, this parent plant produces a number of spore scales. The number of spore scales are sporangia. This is the sporangia, which on maturity it burst out, okay, and release there are some several spores. So being a very light, they reach long distance and far of the place. So each spore is a small microscopic structure with a thick wall. Okay, it is well protected to the withstand unfavorable condition like the dryness, very low, high temperature, humidity because of the hard covering. Okay, on finding the favorable condition, these spores germinate into the new plant. And this is the hypha that is attached to the sporangia. Okay, next is the homework part of this lecture. So the first question is, a fungus, moss and fern reproduce by a common method of asexual reproduction. So you have to name the method. Second question is, explain the different type of reproduction like asexual and sexual reproduction. Only the asexual reproduction you have to define. Third one is, write the observation of all the activities in your FAIR notebook. Okay, this is it about this video. Hope you have understood this video. Thank you and have a nice day.